Hey there, Brainiacs. I'm Allie Astrocyte, and I am getting uncomfortably close to the end of my PhD program, which has me thinking a lot about something that a bunch of our viewers have been asking us to make a video on, which is, what can you do with a degree in neuroscience? The thing is, there are all kinds of different degrees in neuroscience, from a bachelor's on up to a doctorate or a medical degree, and there are all kinds of careers for people with a background in neuroscience. So to distract myself from my job hunt, I decided to do a little bit of research into what kinds of careers are available to neuroscientists. I also invited a bunch of other people to contribute short videos explaining what they're doing with their degrees in neuroscience. So make sure you stick around to the end to see what other people are working on. The traditional career path in neuroscience looks something like this. First, you start by getting an undergraduate degree in neuroscience or in a related field, like psychology or biology. From there, you either do a master's degree or you spend a year or two working as a research technician to gain some practical lab experience. Then you apply to a 4 to 6 year PhD program and then on to a 2 to 6 year postdoctoral fellowship before you finally start applying for faculty jobs. Once you get a job as a faculty member and a PI, or primary investigator, you get to run your own research lab. Usually that includes training junior scientists and teaching classes for undergrads. The thing is, this is actually no longer the traditional career path in neuroscience. Even though lots of people are still getting PhDs in neuroscience, faculty jobs are getting harder and harder to find, and it's an incredibly competitive job market. Some people literally spend years applying to hundreds of jobs and never end up getting a faculty position. On top of that, some people just don't actually want to be PIs of their own labs, so a lot of people are exploring non-academic or alt-ac career paths instead, and there are a lot of different options available. I'm going to talk a little bit about the different kinds of degrees you can get in neuroscience and what kinds of jobs are available to people with those kinds of degrees. So first up, you can get a bachelor's degree in neuroscience, which would include either a bachelor's of science or a bachelor's of arts, and that really just has more to do with what kinds of requirements your university has for your degree. Once you have your undergraduate degree, you could do, first of all, what I did, which is I got a job as a research technician in a lab, and I helped a scientist do a bunch of research on endocrinology. So these tend to be sort of support staff positions where you'd be helping other scientists with their experiments and data analysis. And it's actually really good preparation if you want to pursue another degree in neuroscience like a doctorate or a medical degree, because it actually gives you a chance to like get in lab and do hands-on research. Aside from being a research technician, you can also get a job in industry, which usually would be kind of similar. So in industry, you would also be doing research support, you'd be assisting with research. It just has a more industrial, typically a pharmaceutical bent, although not always. And often has sort of a more like corporate bent too, right? Because it's gonna be like a little bit more profit driven. You could also go into education. So that could include becoming like a STEM teacher in a K-12 classroom, or you could work in an informal education setting. So like a science museum, or developing curricula, or things like that. An undergraduate degree in neuroscience would also provide opportunities for you to get involved in science writing. So you could become like a science journalist and write for a media outlet, or you could write for like online platforms, like digital media, video platforms, or you could do science writing for like an academic journal or something like that. You could also get into science advocacy and science policy, so advocating for better funding for science or science education using your technical background in neuroscience. And finally, you could also get into academic administration, which would be working for a university in an administrative capacity. So this could include things like overseeing degree programs or overseeing student body programs. There's lots of opportunities available in academic settings for people with backgrounds in STEM fields. So I'm a little bit less familiar with what you can do with a master's degree in neuroscience, mostly because I never looked into getting one because it didn't make sense for my career plans, but I know that there are a few things you can do, including continuing to pursue the academic route. So often people who don't feel like they had a very good GPA in undergrad will get a master's degree in neuroscience to sort of buff up and show that they're ready for the lab. This can also be for people who don't have an undergraduate background in neuroscience but really want to go into neuroscience in the future. But if you don't plan on going on to a PhD, you can also just work as a research associate in a lab doing research as a scientist. You can also get a job working for an industry company as a research scientist, and I actually think it's more common to find master's level scientists in industry companies. You could also pursue a career in education, so you could teach, as I said before, you could teach high school students or elementary school students, or you could teach as an adjunct lecturer at a community college or at a university. Other things you can do with a master's degree in neuroscience include things like science writing, science journalism, you could get into policy and advocacy, acting as a consultant, You could get into data science and do data science work. The thing about a lot of these other career paths that you can pursue with a master's degree in neuroscience is that a lot of them will require some kind of additional training. Maybe not like formal schooling, like another degree, but some kind of like short training program or on-the-job training. Just because you're gonna mostly be trained to do research and not trained as much to do these other things. So what can you do with a PhD in neuroscience? That's the question that's been on my mind a lot lately, because I'm trying to figure out what I'm gonna do with my PhD in neuroscience. So I could go the obvious route, which is to do a postdoctoral fellowship. So as a postdoctoral scientist, you typically have a little bit more independence than you would have as a PhD scientist. The goal is sort of training you to be more independent as a researcher and to hopefully eventually help you launch your own lab. At least typically that's the goal. If you don't want to go the academic route, there are also a lot of jobs available in industry for PhD level scientists. So pretty similar sort of setup where you're sort of a more independent scientist, but typically working under an investigator and under the guidance of other scientists and working collaboratively with other scientists in the lab. Another popular route that people are interested in is advocacy and policy. So a bunch of scientific professional societies offer fellowship opportunities to help new PhD graduates get involved in science policy. So this can include acting like as a consultant for politicians to help them better understand scientific issues. It can include advocating for science policy, like advocating for better scientific funding or science education. And it can also include working for an organization or a nonprofit that's interested in, for example, focusing on curing Alzheimer's disease. So there's opportunities available in that sector as well. You can also pursue a career in writing, but typically if you're interested in science journalism, you really don't need the PhD. If you're interested in technical writing, the PhD is actually pretty essential. And technical writing is essentially where you help other scientists write grants and write their papers. So this can mean finding a position at a university or at a private research institute where you help other scientists develop these ideas and produce grants to hopefully get funding. People with PhDs in neuroscience can also go into consulting or patent law. So often this includes acting as a consultant in sort of the biotech and pharmaceutical industry to sort of consult on scientific issues, and particularly with a focus on patent law, basically kind of have to do some additional training in that, but essentially I don't really know what you actually do, but I do know you can make a lot of money doing it, so it's very appealing to some people. Kind of the last like big field that I know of a lot of people with neuroscience PhDs going into is data science. So data scientists typically end up working more in the tech sector, although not always, and data science usually involves sort of using and analyzing very large data sets to inform decisions made by the company or organization. A lot of students who do neuroscience research in graduate programs end up doing a lot of coding and sort of data science related stuff for their data analysis. And that creates this really valuable skill set that then makes them very desirable candidates for data science jobs. And then of course, there are all kinds of other little things you can do. I know tons of people who've ended up becoming freelancers. I know people who've gone on to essentially become just like public speakers and science communicators. So there's lots of things you can do with a PhD in neuroscience. And finally, you could get a medical degree. So technically a medical degree is not a degree in neuroscience, but often people who are interested in neuroscience will pursue that because you can go into a specialty like neurology or psychiatry. I also know a bunch of people who have gotten MD-PhDs, which are dual degrees where you get both a doctorate in neuroscience and a medical degree. And these are what we call medical scientists. So these are people who are trained both in a clinical setting to work with patients, but also in a research lab. And these people often end up doing clinical research where they take the stuff that's been discovered in regular basic science labs and try to translate it into patient populations. So as you can see, there are a lot of different careers available to people with degrees in neuroscience. And now I'm gonna have a bunch of my friends tell you what they do with their degrees.
Hey Neurotransmissions, I love your work, please keep it up. So I'm Adam Tozer, I have a PhD in neuroscience, I study as an electrophysiologist. After 4 years of postdocing, I left the rig to become a science writer. I ran the neuroscience Facebook page, Neuroscience News and Research. More recently, I've turned my hand to scientific content creation, and I'm doing this, we'll be starting a new job for a company called Synthase shortly. But in my spare time, I still advocate for neuroscience research, and you can find me on Facebook and Twitter at Adam Tozer Neuro.
Hi, I'm Alycia Mosley Austin. I have both a bachelor's and a PhD in neuroscience. I'm an academic administrator at the University of Rhode Island. I'm assistant dean of the grad school, and I'm also associate director of the interdisciplinary neuroscience program. So I have a fully administrative position in the graduate program.
Hi, my name is Nick Wan. I have a PhD in neuroscience and I'm one of the data scientists for the Cincinnati Reds. On a typical game day, my view looks like this.
Hi, my name is Nour Al-muhtasib. I got my PhD in pharmacology with a focus in neuroscience. I'm currently a postdoctoral fellow in the neuroscience department, and I study how endocannabinoids modulate inhibition in the cortex.
Hi, my name is Anna Mingorance. I have a PhD in neuroscience, and I'm the owner and principal of Trocana Consultant. I was always involved in way too many projects to keep a boss happy, so eventually I embraced that, became an independent consultant, and now I work with many different clients looking for therapies for rare neurological diseases, and I love being an independent consultant.
Hi, my name is Kevin Horecka. My undergraduate degree was in computer science and my PhD was in neuroscience. I'm currently working in AI as a data scientist and machine learning engineer for Walmart Technology and a volunteer data scientist and researcher for Austin Pets Alive, an animal shelter here in Austin, Texas.
Hello, my name is Kaliris Salas-Ramirez, and I work at the CUNY School of Medicine as an assistant medical professor. My research focuses on looking at interventions for cognitive decline as a result of both illicit and therapeutic drug exposure, with a focus on developmental drug exposure, as well as sex differences for these interventions to look at efficacy of treatments for patients.
Hey there, I'm Jens. I studied psychology in Germany. I got a PhD in neuropsychology in Germany, and then I transferred over to Florida where I study the brain using fMRI, neuroimaging, and other methods.
Hi, I'm Ginny. I studied natural sciences at the University of Cambridge, specializing in psychology and neuroscience, and now I work as a science communicator. I write books and blogs about science, I make podcasts, I have my own YouTube channel, and I also go to festivals and schools and do stage shows all about the brain.
Hi, my name is Brittney Fair, and I have a master's degree in neuroscience. I am the science writer for the Salk Institute of Biological Studies in La Jolla, California. At Salk, I meet with scientists to write press releases for their upcoming publications. I also co-host and co-produce the podcast, and I write articles for the Inside Salk magazine.
Bonjour, I'm Gonzalo, and I got a master's degree in neuroscience at the Aix-Marseille University. It's in France, by the way. Today, I'm a scientific communicator and entrepreneur. It means that I do the best job of the world. I talk about neuroscience every day. I created a YouTube channel, Drop of Curiosity, and I make videos about neurons and brain, like neurotransmission, but in French.
Hi, my name is Dr. Jaclyn Dunphy, and I recently earned a PhD in neuroscience from Tufts University, where I studied how astrocytes talk to neurons at the tripartite synapse. Now, I'm working in the exciting field of biotechnology, where I work with a lot of other scientists to found and fund new life science companies. I call what I do entrepreneur science, because I get to combine my love for the brain with the need for making new medicines and therapies that will improve human health.
Hi, my name is Thiago Arzua. I am a third-year PhD student here at the Medical College of Wisconsin, and I'm getting my PhD in neuroscience. My current work focuses on stem cells and how those can be models for certain neurological diseases. And more specifically, I study things called cerebral organoids. They can also be called mini brains, and I think they're very cool.
Hi, my name is Phaedra, and I got my bachelor's degree in psychology with a minor in neuroscience from Southern Illinois University at Carbondale. And now I'm a second year graduate student in the Kent State Biomedical Sciences Neuroscience program, and I'm pursuing a PhD focusing on learning and memory. And that's what I did with my degree in neuroscience.
Hello, my name is Andrew Neff. I did my PhD in neuroscience studying the connections between the gut microbiome and the brain. I now teach part-time psychology at a local university, and I started my own business creating science media.
Hi, Neurotransmissions. My name is V, and I did my PhD studying the cognitive neuroscience of the human visual system. And now, I'm a research scientist at Intel, and I'm applying what we know about the brain to help develop more sophisticated artificial intelligence and machine learning techniques.
Hi, my name is Justin Kiggins. I have a PhD in neuroscience from the University of California in San Diego. Now I work as a product manager, building open source software for scientists to analyze and visualize their data.
Thank you to everyone who contributed to this video. It's really fun to get to show off all of these amazing neuroscientists and all the cool work that they're doing. So even though I'm really stressed these days about finishing my PhD and applying for all these jobs and keeping neurotransmissions going and all the other cool stuff I get to do all the time, it's really exciting to think about all of the possibilities that are available to me. And I'm really excited to see what comes next in my career. But whatever happens as I go through this whole process and life transition, I'm really excited to take you on the journey with me. And until our next transmission, I'm Alie Astrocyte. Over and out.
What can you do with a neuro degree? What can you do with a neuro degree? What can you do with a neuro degree after you graduate? Way, hey, I get a job. Way, hey, I get a job. Way, hey, I get a job. Or will I be unemployed? Maybe it's the best to go to grad school. Maybe you can teach kids STEM, that sounds cool. Maybe you can just delay and then you'll learn when you graduate. Way, hey, I get a job. Way, hey, I get a job. Way, hey, I get a job. Or will I be unemployed? Maybe there's a job in science writing. Maybe I should go and do consulting. Maybe this whole process feels insulting after I graduate. Wait. Way, hey, I get a job. Way, hey, I get a job. Way, hey, I get a job. Or will I be unemployed?